Published 0317 EDT, the 1st of September 2017. Updated 0450 EDT, the 1st of September 2017. The wreckage of a World War II RAF plane that helped drive the Nazis from Norway has been found at the bottom of the North Sea 70 years after it vanished without trace. National Grid engineers were astonished to find a short Stirling heavy bomber off the Norwegian city of Stavanger. It is believed to have vanished while taking supplies from Britain to resistance forces in Nazi-occupied Norway towards the end of the war. Indiana, 19445. National Grid engineers were astonished to find a short Stirling heavy bomber off the Norwegian city of Stavanger. Pictured the wheel of the plane wreckage mangled. This image shows some of the rusting metal from the plane resting at the bottom of the sea. Power. The short Stirling was a British four-engined heavy bomber of the Second World War discovery. The wreckage was found off the coast of Stavanger in the south of Norway. The engineers made the discovery while scanning the seabed with sonar equipment along the proposed route of a Norway electricity cable link. It is not known exactly how the plane went down, but expert Bengt Stangvik said the four-engine aircraft struggled to exceed an altitude of 15,000 feet, making it a target for Luftwaffe fighters. He said several Stirlings disappeared without a trace on missions to Norway in winter 194,445. The short Stirling was a British four-engined heavy bomber of the Second World War. It has the distinction of being the first four-engine bomber to be introduced into service with the Royal Air Force. Wingspan 30 m TOP, speed 410 km, length 27 m, number built 2371, designer Arthur Gouge. First flight May 14, 1939. National origin United Kingdom. Based on the location of this wreck, it is probable that it was on a mission to drop supplies to the resistance forces in western Norway. 19 of the 30 British aircraft which vanished during the Norwegian resistance were short Stirlings, he added, of which 6 are unaccounted for. After finding the wreckage, engineers sent a camera down on a remote-controlled underwater vehicle to inspect it. Nigel Williams, North Sea Link Project Director for National Grid, said when images of what appeared to be an aircraft wheel came through, "You can imagine our surprise. It was only when experts investigated the images in more detail that we learned there was a strong possibility it could be a British aircraft that served during World War II. Sadly, it appears the pilot and the crew of this particular aircraft were never able to complete their mission." The Joint Casualty and Compassionate Center JCCC at the Ministry of Defense was notified so it could investigate any links to missing British servicemen. The JCCC said the identity of the aircraft could not be confirmed until it had received positive evidence. RAF Bomber Command crew loading bombs onto a short Stirling bomber aircraft. Our boys in World War II. A short Stirling crew getting ready for their next raid. A spokesman for National Grid said that engineers have made a careful record of the wreckage site. He added, "We will go around it to ensure that the wreck is not disturbed." Under the Protection of Military Remains Act 1986, the site of the wreckage is protected and could become classed as a war grave. Sue Raftery of the JCCC said discoveries at sea are relatively rare due to their very location. A number of aircraft are known to have been lost in the North Sea during the course of the Second World War, but we need positive evidence before we can confirm. We would class this aircraft as a war grave. It is protected under the Protection of Military Remains Act 1986, which covers crashed military aircraft in both UK territorial and international waters. The North Sea Link will be the world's longest subsea interconnector when it becomes operational in 2021. The 447-mile cable will run between Northumberland in the UK and Suldal in Norway. The German occupation of Norway began on the 9th of April 1940 after German forces invaded the neutral country. Norway surrendered on the 10th of June 1940 and the Germans then controlled the country until the capitulation of German forces in Europe on May 8, 1945. Norway was occupied by the Wehrmacht and led by the Reichskommissariat, Norwegian Reichskommissariat of Norway, collaborating with a Progerman puppet government. The Norwegian king and pre-war government escaped to London, where they acted as a government in exile.